Hi there and welcome. My name is Michael Kentenich and I'm a Microsoft technical trainer. In this video, get ready to empower your applications with elasticity and efficiency using autoscale. Imagine a bustling e-commerce platform during a flash sale event. Customers are flooding in, eager to snag the latest gadgets at discounted prices. Suddenly, the website experiences a surge in traffic, overwhelming the servers. Here's where Azure App Service autoscaling comes to the rescue. With autoscale, the platform dynamically adjusts its resources, adding more instances when demand spikes and scaling down during quieter times. This ensures a seamless shopping experience for users, preventing crashes and slowdowns of the service, not the users, but you knew this, right? And the developers like you can focus on building features rather than worrying about server capacity. Autoscaling optimizes costs by allocating resources only when needed. In this video, we will look at how to identify the scenarios for which autoscaling is an appropriate solution, create autoscaling rules for a web app, and monitor the effects of autoscaling. With the autoscale feature of Azure App Service, you can create intelligent rules that specify when to add or remove instances. It's like having an elastic workforce, scaling up seamlessly when the load increases and gracefully scaling down during quieter times. Not only does this enhance performance, but it also optimizes costs, ensuring your enterprise stays agile and efficient. Can you think of more good reasons for autoscale other than providing elasticity? Improving the availability of your distributed application or providing an extra layer of fault tolerance would be two more. When you configure autoscale, you can create rules based on metrics and you define which ones to monitor because you know best how to tell if your application needs to be scaled out or not. Your app service plan can also scale on a schedule, or even mix a schedule with metrics-based rules and several other conditions. Here's a list of what autoscale can act upon. Could be memory percentage, disk queue length, HTTP queue length, or some others that are specific to an app service plan's resources. And now next, I will show you how to configure autoscale in a demo. In this video, I will show you how to enable autoscale for your app service. I have this Contoso HTML app service here running on an app service plan. Now, this app service plan currently is in the pricing tier F1, in the free one. It doesn't cost me anything, but it also doesn't have all the features. And autoscale is one of the features that you have only from standard upwards. So the first thing I need to do before I'm able to use autoscale, I need to upgrade the pricing tier. And I can also show you that it's not going to work in this sense, because if I go to scale out, showing you what options are available, then it repeats the current plan right now. And it shows me here that these scale out methods are all disabled. So I don't have any scaling operations available. Yeah, let's go ahead and change this first. Upgrading the plan can be done at any point in time. You can even downgrade it at some point if you want to revert such a step. But I will go and use the standard S1 right now, which definitely has autoscale. How can I tell? I'm looking at the hardware view right now. But if I switch this to the feature view, you can see here it has a column for autoscale. And if I go down, it has rules. And that means it is not only offering me the manual option I have with basic, it has also this rules setup that I want. So I will change this. And now the app service plan is going to be updated. Now that I have this updated and it shows me here the standard S1,
plan, I can see that now I can configure both manual and rules-based. I want to change the rules-based, and it's a bit strange, but the way to get to autoscale from here is you have to enable rules-based first, and then you click this link, Manage Rules Basic Scaling. That brings you to the autoscale setting part. You can switch, and you can always switch between manual and custom autoscale, which is autoscale. If you want at some point to switch back to manual and just set up some instances that you want. So I could just change this to 4, save it, and then I will have 4 instances running on my app services right now. But I want to set this up using rules that are based on a metric. By enabling this, you can see here there's a default profile. And in this default profile, I can add multiple scale conditions based on a metric, based on a schedule, and I can even mix and match them. But in this demo, I just want to show you how you would leverage this metric-based scaling. So select scale based on a metric, and then, and that is a bit hard to find sometimes, there is one link hidden in this text box here saying add a rule, because that is where we actually say what we want to do. So just click add a rule and it will open up a side blade to let you configure a scale rule. It has loaded the namespace for the app service plan already, and it gives me a list of different metrics available. CPU related, data related, disks, or TCP, or socket information, status codes, errors that are happening, all the things that might be interesting to determine the kind of workload that you are app services are experiencing. So I will go with CPU percentage for now. And what I want to do is if the percentage goes over 85% within 10 minutes on average. So for 10 minutes, it's looking, what is the average in the last 10 minutes? And if it's going over 85, it should do something. And that something it should do is increase by one instance. If I have one right now, I will have 2 after this. I can choose either to add a count by a number, a percentage, or to a specific number. I can jump from 1 to 10 right away if I want this. So you pick whatever makes most sense for your configuration. The cooldown minutes here, although they might be with 5 minutes a bit high, this is something super important because we don't want to have a ton of instances added in a very short amount of time. So what this 5 minutes here means is if we get added an instance, it will wait for 5 minutes before it does anything else. So to add another instance, although if the 85% are still the average, it will take 5 more minutes. But that is an important thing, not to have that flip-flop situations where you constantly either get increased or decrease of instances. So let's add this one rule. And you can see here, this has been phrased as a scale out rule now. Why? Because we have this action here to increase the count. But I don't want to end up with having more instances that I actually need. So I always should configure also a scale in rule. So I pretty much do the opposite. So I define now a threshold with saying less than or equal to, let's say 25 is a good number here. Again, we're looking for that time frame of 10 minutes in 1 minute grains, and we look for the average. Then we go and decrease the count by 1, right? So, and again, we have that cooldown waiting time embedded in here. And you decide again what makes more sense for your specific scenario. So let's add this, and now I have a scale in and a scale out rule. And all I need to do an additional step is, what is the minimum and the maximum you want? Because yes, yeah, it could add, depending on what the pricing tier allows you to do, you can configure many instances. But what if I want to have the maximum 5? And the minimum should always be 2, because that would be something I would like to consider. If I have 2 instances and the default says here 1, that doesn't work because it says it has to be at least the same or more than minimum. And the default is just sort of a fail-safe configuration where if for some reason the current count cannot actually be determined by the system, it will make sure that you always end up having at least these default settings, so 2. But of course, it cannot be lower than minimum. It has to be within minimum and maximum, like I just said. So when I click now save, 2 things will happen. First of all, this rule will be stored at metadata and it will be enabled. And you can check the rule like it is, looks like here. And also, because I switched instance limit from minimum 1 to 2, it will create another instance in the backend. So at some point, if I look in here, if I look for the run history, it hasn't really put this into effect yet, because at some point it will tell me here what is the observed capacity. So it should say at least 1 or 2, depending on when it's going to be updated. And if there are instances added and removed or removed, then I can see this here in either in a graphical representation or in a list of operations. But it will take some time until this is actually be updated. And once that configuration is updated, you can just go ahead also and let yourself notify if that happens. You can send out an email to administrators, co-administrators, add some additional email addresses in here, or trigger even a webhook, so you get always the full picture and be notified when any of those operations happen.
To sum up the autoscale configuration best practices, ensure the maximum minimum values are specific to the use case of your solution. Make sure that you have the appropriate statistics for your diagnostic metric. Make sure also that the thresholds are always adjusted to what you have in check. And always also look for the default instance count, because that becomes important when the minimum and maximum cannot individually determined for some reason because of a platform issue at that time. Congratulations on diving into the intricacies of autoscale within Azure App Service. By understanding autoscale factors and crafting effective autoscale conditions, you're prepared to optimize your app's performance and resource utilization effortlessly. Take control of your app scalability with autoscale and ensure seamless user experiences under varying workloads. Thanks for watching and keep on learning.